today, an unearthed quote of Cory Booker's from a town hall that he hosted in February made the rounds on the internet from a Huffington Post article. He likened himself to a civil rights icon to laud his record with charter schools and education when he was mayor of Newark. And it's pretty cringeworthy, and terrible, embarrassing. All of the above? I was like Malcolm X, Booker, a senator from New Jersey, told an Iowa crowd in February of his time as Newark's mayor. He went on to cite a quote he has used for nearly two decades to justify his centrist brand of education reform. By any means necessary, my kids were going to get an education. Centrist, that's exactly what it is. By any means necessary, we were going to sap the public schools of necessary resources and put them into charter schools. Yeah, by any means necessary. I mean, what a comparison. Malcolm X was a revolutionary. He was even more radical than Martin Luther King Jr., as we all learned in history class, and I'm certainly not using radical as a pejorative the way many in the media would. I think Malcolm X is a great American, was a great American. That's a high bar you're setting for yourself, Cory Booker, so you better have the results to back it up, right? When the general public thinks of education in Newark and Cory Booker, they likely have an image of the then mayor sitting on Oprah's couch with then Governor Chris Christie, Republican, of course, and Facebook's Mark Zuckerberg, who pledged $100 million to the Newark school system right before The Social Network was supposed to come out, which is a movie that did not paint him in the best light, to say the least. Also, David Fincher's best movie. It's a perfect movie. Sorry, I love Fight Club. I love Zodiac. Love all of his movies, basically. But yeah, that's my take. Hot take. Anyway, even if the $100 million was a stunt by Zuckerberg, who has a ton of problems, it's still a great gesture as long as the $100 million is going towards things in the correct way. And that really wasn't the case. Christie and Booker's administrations went on to change the way teachers were evaluated, dramatically expand charter schools, and revamp the city's enrollment system. Booker and his allies described the efforts as an unequivocal success, citing research that shows district gains in reading achievement and graduation rates, and arguing criticism is misleading and short-sighted. But some Newark residents said they are mistrustful of the data that has come out about the district. They claim that potential gains have occurred in spite of the changes Booker spurred, not because of them. They remain angry and resentful of their former mayor, who they say handed their schools and children over to money-hungry consultants in the name of national recognition. I think Booker has done a lot of good things in his career as a senator, but it rings true. National recognition, cameras, attention. That's my subjective read on him as a politician. He has never met a camera he doesn't like, in the vein of Bill Clinton and so many before him. And also Booker and the concept of contracting out work to consultants and contractors during his time as mayor was not a good mix. If you followed my reporting on the Newark Watershed Corporation and the leg crisis that's ongoing there, the Watershed was embroiled in a huge bribery scandal where multiple people went to jail under Booker's watch. The people who went to jail got in trouble for handing out fact contracts to people, to contractors that were not qualified, and then taking money off the top. And now there's lead in the water. I mean, it was probably always there, but they did not address it, partly because they were too worried about enriching themselves illegally. So back to the Malcolm X comment. I don't have the audio. I don't know if that was said in jest or whatever. It does not seem that way. It seems pretty self-serious. And it's cringy because Malcolm X certainly wouldn't have supported AIPAC and Israeli militants. That's like the biggest understatement of the world. He would have been a strong BDSer, I can tell you that now. He would not have supported banning drugs coming over from Canada that would have lowered drug prices to protect pharmaceutical company donors and more. Those are just some of the things that Cory Booker has done. And so I think that while comparing yourself to Malcolm X may be an exercise in inflating one's ego and maybe an electoral strategy, it's a bit dishonoring to the legacy of Malcolm X and does not take into account the many sacrifices and his brave and bold radicalism, because Cory Booker is certainly not Malcolm X, and his brand of charter school corporatism is certainly not in the vein of Malcolm X. And I find the quote a little embarrassing, and I hope that he reassesses.